Good morning, church. Morning. My name is Wee Teck. Very good morning to all of you. Sermon title for today is God Will Make a Way, as we have seen, we have just sung. Like to introduce, I'm sure all of you know me and my family very well by now, because you've been praying for us all these years as we were in the mission field. But that's a picture of my family and I at the Methodist Center in Phnom Penh, Cambodia, in matching outfits, in traditional Khmer outfits. And that word in the slide there reads "Sua Stai," which translates to "hello" in Khmer, right? So good morning. I bring you greetings. I've just come back from serving in the field for 8 years, as I've said in the video. We've just been, Chulon and Nathan came back last year, a bit earlier, just to prepare him for his education. He's in P1 in Fairfield, and I've just come back for a couple of months right now, 5 months right now. Right, so next slide. This is the Methodist School of Cambodia. That was my last post in the last 4 years, 2018 to 2022. The school has a history of 25 years now. And while our sister Annabella was mentioned just now, I think some of you remember contributing as well. There is a plaque in her memory for one of the classrooms on the ground floor. It used to be a kindergarten. Now it's a P1 classroom. And she was really the trailblazer of the school. She was there 1996, 1997. The school was officially started in 97. And so, if your math serves you right, this year the school will be celebrating 25 years anniversary. You can find the school on Facebook. The students have been doing community service as part of celebrating God's faithfulness and God's goodness. So this is where I was. Right now, there is a dear brother. His name is Timothy, who's taking over as the principal of the school. In other works, you are also very familiar that Aldersgate has a slum street children ministry, Hope House, a Methodist hostel for the undergraduate students, as well as Prek Ompel Methodist Church. And later on, I will bring greetings from Pastor Ratana, Pastor So Paul, as well as our brothers and sisters in Prek Ompel Methodist Church through video, not live, but through recorded video. So, with that, anyone can read that in Khmer? Okay, if you cannot read that, you must join Retake's Khmer lessons. Jo Atitan Yung Tiang Oknia, let us pray before we go to the Lord's word. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks on this Lord's Day this morning. Your people from all over the world are gathered in your name to worship you and to learn more about you. And we ask, O Lord, today, as Aldersgate Methodist Church, as a community of faith, we want to hear your voice speaking to us of what this mission is all about, how you make a way for each and every one of us to have access to our Heavenly Father. So Lord, may your Holy Spirit fill this place and remove any distraction that we may hear your still small voice speaking to each and every one of us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Scripture is taken from Isaiah chapter 43, verses 14 to 21. Let me read that for all of us. Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, for your sake I send to Babylon and bring them all down as fugitives, even the Chaldeans, in the ships in which they rejoice. I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. Thus says the Lord, who makes a way in the sea, a path in the mighty waters, who brings forth chariot and horse, army and warrior. They lie down, they cannot rise. They are extinguished, quenched like a wick. Remember not the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The wild beasts will honor me, the jackals and the ostriches, for I give water in the wilderness, rivers in the desert, to drink, to give drink to my chosen people, the people whom I formed for myself, that they may declare my praise. The theme for this Missions Month is missions in a post-pandemic world. I think this passage of Scripture reminds us of how missions, the mission of missions, why we are doing missions. And it starts with God's redemptive plan. In verses 14 and 15, it says that the Lord, our Redeemer, He is fighting on our behalf. He goes forth and fights on our behalf. He is the Holy One, the Creator of Israel, our King. I wonder how many of us have gone to look at our notice boards in the social hall. I once chanced upon it on one of my return trips back, short trips back, and I saw this on the notice board for missions. Pardon me, the words are a bit too small, but it says there, missions is the overflow of our delight in God, because missions is the overflow of God's delight in being God. This quotation is attributed to John Piper, but it has also been found in another book. I do not know who said it first, but nonetheless, it reminds us the reason why we are doing missions, it has to start and it has to end because God first came to us. God sent His only Son, Jesus Christ. I spent 8 years in Cambodia, and when I went over, I heard that MMS, as an organization, we have been there for 20 over years. And as a cross-cultural missions, inadvertently, we step on each other's toes. You see, the reason why we go into the field is first and foremost to bring reconciliation, healing, the healing power of the gospel of Christ. But in the midst of doing so, because of that cross-cultural, the differences in the cultures, the differences in worldviews, the differences in languages, we step on each other's toes, we hurt each other. And so when I was sharing with my mentors, church leaders, that I was planning to come back, it was 1 year ago, they shared with me, we take end well. End well and find closure for that chapter of your life. At that time, I was thinking to myself, what does that mean? What does that look like? So I just carry on as per normal, but the Lord started to do an amazing work in my last month in Cambodia. He started to give me opportunities to find resolutions, to find closures, to submit unto the Lord what I have done, what I could have done, what I did not do, what I did wrong as well. And the amazing thing, nobody could have orchestrated this except for the Lord. Right up to the last moment, when I was boarding that train, my son loves train, subconsciously it's gone into my brain. When I was boarding that plane to come home, bags packed and all, I don't like to wait in the queue, so I was the last person. The flight was quite full. Somebody called out my name. We take. I was thinking to myself, who on earth will recognize me on the flight back home? I turned, I saw that face. That was the person. 3 years, I haven't been talking to him. He's a local church leader in Cambodia. He's Cambodian. Why haven't we spoken for 3 years? Because 3 years ago on Christmas, I stepped on his toe. I offended him. And that phone call didn't end well. And we haven't spoken to each other in 3 years. And brothers and sisters, that wasn't even on my mind when I was thinking about seeking resolution. But the Lord brought that person into my path. He was on his way to Jakarta on a connecting flight in Singapore. I said, let's talk when we touch down. When we touched down, I was looking out for him. Couldn't see him for a while, but I finally saw him. I went up to him and I said, we haven't spoken for 3 years. I want to say to you, I am sorry. And he apologized as well for that conversation. And we prayed together. We prayed a blessing for the ministry, for MMS, as well as for the local church. And that was a powerful moment that I don't think I will ever forget in my life. I never expected that I would do that on my flight back. I thought I could just tune into Netflix. But the Lord brought that. And this is the work of the Lord. We are in missions because this is God's work. We are at our Father's business. And this is the work of redemption that the Lord wants to work in each of our lives. So, we could look on to the next verses of how the Lord has brought us through in our lives, how the Lord has redeemed us. Israel was at a moment in their history where they were in exile in Babylon, and they were desperately crying out to God for salvation, for redemption. And the future looked very bleak for them. The Lord brought to their mind what He has done. For 40 years, they had been enslaved in Egypt, and the Lord brought this picture back to their mind. The crossing of the Red Sea, as they look forward into a very bleak situation, a whole nation there, and the vast sea ahead of them, no way that they could cross that sea. And as they look back, that raging chariot and army coming towards them, wanting to wipe them out. Moses held up the staff, and the Lord made a way in that water. And that was God trying to remind the Israelites, I have done it before. I will do it again. I have brought you salvation and redemption. I will do it again. I had the privilege of having Chiu Luan go to Cambodia 2 years earlier. She went in 2012. I went in 2014 after we got married. When I went there, I didn't have the driving license. She had the driving license. And right up to today, I think some of you have sat in that white color van before, that Toyota white color van. Manual stick shift, no power steering. And she drives around in that van. So we went out for a meal, and we were looking for a parking place. If you have been to Cambodia, you know that you have to mount the curb in order to park. So in that no power steering, manual shift, she ran, she saw that parking lot, pop, go up to the curb, mount the curb, and park. Head in first. And that is the way that they park in Cambodia. In Singapore, if you mount curb, if you hit curb, immediate failure. In Cambodia, you must mount curb, then you can pass. Not only that, I had the privilege that she, if you know my wife, you know that she has the memory of an elephant. She can remember every detail. So I had the privilege of her sharing with me this person, how is this person connected to this person, and what we have done before, and so on and so forth. What has happened before? So she's the walking archives. If you ever want to know what happened in missions in Aldersgate, you can find her also. And that is what the Lord has been doing in our lives. 2013, as I sought the Lord for a missions call, because at that time, I wanted to be with Chulon, and I literally chased her into the mission field. But at the same time, I say, God, I cannot be going to Cambodia because of Chulon. So I sought the Lord for a calling. I said, Lord, what is your portion for me? The Lord brought me back to memory to when I was 13 years old, and I received the Lord as my personal Lord and Savior. And that seed of the gospel took root in my heart, and how my mentors, my BB officers, my teachers from Fairfield, youth leaders in Aldersgate had watered and sowed into my life and helped that seed take root and grow in my life. And that changed my destiny forever. I was sharing at the Chinese service last week, and I was just sharing of how I was a very poor student. Academically, I was a poor student in school. You will not believe this. I barely scraped through Chinese, English. And then lo and behold, as I went into my adult years, I went into Cambodia, I learned a third language. That is only because of God's amazing work in my life. And the gospel literally has a life-changing effect in my life. And so I think as God's people, we must continue to remember what the Lord has done. We must continue to give praise to Him for what He has done and to tell that story, because each and every one of us have a story to tell. And so up to today, the Israelites are still telling that story of how the Lord brought them through the Red Sea. But the sad thing is this, we cannot remain in the past. Verse 18 and 19, the Lord says, remember not the former things, consider not the things of old. Behold, I am doing a new thing. We all know up to today, there are still certain portions of Israelites yearning and waiting for the arrival of Messiah. What is this new thing that the Lord is telling the Israelites? It is the arrival of Messiah, Jesus Christ our Lord. Because God is not here to just save the Israelites. If not, then we will not be here today. He yearns for all His children to come back to the saving knowledge of who He is. And so when Jesus came to die on the cross, He died for all of our sins. It says in Scripture, do you not perceive it? As God's people, what is the next season of missions in a post-pandemic world that the Lord is doing? Let us go to the Lord, sit at His foot, seek the Lord, what He would have us do, what He is doing in our midst, and what is our portion in that whole grand scheme of things. And with that, I would like to bring to you some words from Pastor Ratana, some greetings from Pastor Ratana, from Pastor Sopal. I think it's been a while. They were here, if I'm not wrong, it was in 2008. I'm not sure. In any case, it's been a while, and I think we are all looking forward to hear from them. And so with that, they will share with us how things have been like at Prac Ompo Church the last 2 years, and what we can continue to partner them in prayer in the years ahead.
ខ្ញុំមានកូនបីនាក់កូនទី1ឈ្មោះរតនាសំយោអាយហើយឆ្នាំនេះគាត់អាយុបាន12ឆ្នាំហើយហើយកូនទី2ឈ្មោះរតនាទេពិថាគាត់អាយុ10ឆ្នាំហើយកូនទី3គឺឈ្មោះរតនាទេបូរ៉ាគឺគាត់អាយុ8ឆ្នាំហើយបាទអរគុណដល់យើងអរគុណរតនាជាគ្រូរៀនលើព្រះសំពៅជាពេលដល់4ឆ្នាំដែរបាទអរគុណដល់ដែលបងបានជឿនឹងខ្ញុំឲ្យជួយមកធ្វើជាគ្រូរៀនលើទីនេះ
អំឡុងពេលពីរឆ្នាំដែលយើងជួបបញ្ហាកូវីដកើតឡើងគឺយើងក៏
ួយបារម្ភអំពីពួកជំនុំនឹងត្រូវស្ដាប់ចាយឬយ៉ាងម៉េចដែរអញ្ចឹងណាប៉ុន្តែយើងមកអធិដ្ឋានហើយយើងបានរៀបចំគម្រោងជាច្រើនថាយើងត្រូវធ្វើម៉េចអ្វីអ្វីត្រូវរកថាពិបាកបិទមិនឲ្យយើងជុំជុំអញ្ចឹងណាហើយហាមមិនឲ្យផ្ដុំគ្នាច្រើនអញ្ចឹងអញ្ចឹងពួកខ្ញុំគិតគ្នាថាពួកយើងទិញកាមេរ៉ាទិញកាមេរ៉ាហើយយើងភ្ជាប់ Wi-Fi អ៊ីនធឺណិតផងហើយយើងឡាយអធិប្បាយឡាយសរសើរតម្កើងដល់ព្រះអង្គដើម្បីឲ្យពួកជំនុំនៅជាប់ជាមួយព្រះអង្គ
បាទគុណព្រះអង្គសម្រាប់ផែនការនៅក្នុងក្រុមជំនុំយើងនៅតែបន្តខ្ញុំបង្កើតវគ្គបើកវើនក្នុងឆ្នាំថ្មីនេះដែលនិយាយថាគោលបំណងហើយនិមិត្តរបស់ផងយើងចង់ឲ្យបង្កើតសកម្មភាពបង្កើតសកម្មភាពបន្តអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំចាប់ដើមវគ្គដល់គណៈកម្មការ7នេះបរិសុទ្ធស្រ្តីយុវជនកុមារបេឡាហើយនិងគណៈកម្មការច្រើនទៀតដើម្បីបង្កើតវគ្គបង្កើតហើយសិភៅដែលយើងរៀនហ្នឹងពី MMC មកដែលគាត់បានបង្រៀនយើងពីលោកគ្រូពីសង្ឃគួរមកបានបង្កើតវគ្គឲ្យយើងបានបង្រៀនសិភៅEasy 1, Easy 2, Easy 3, ហើយនឹងមួយទៀតហើយសភៅតបតែថ្មីថ្មីនេះសភៅសាងសង់សំណប់របស់ព្រះអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំបង្រៀនបំពុកវិញដល់គណៈកម្មការទាំងអស់ហើយឲ្យពួកគាត់នៅជាប់ជាមួយនឹងព្រះអង្គទី1សភៅនេះចង់ឲ្យគាត់បានយល់អំពីសេចក្តីសង្គ្រោះយ៉ាងប៉ិនប្រកបនៅក្នុងជីវិតរបស់គាត់តរហើយបន្តមកពីការធានាអង្គការរបស់ព្រះពីបន្តប្រកបតែក្នុងជីវិតរបស់គាត់ដែរហើយគាត់ឲ្យគាត់បាននៅជាប់ជាមួយព្រះអង្គហើយគាត់មានពេលជាមួយព្រះអង្គបាទហើយគាត់មានពេលអានព្រះបន្ទូលព្រះអង្គមួយឆ្នាំម្ដងឬពីរដងតែគាត់អាចធ្វើទៅបានហើយមួយទៀតឲ្យគាត់បានសម្លឹងមើលយើងរៀនសភានឹងចប់ឲ្យគាត់បានសម្លឹងមើលសិស្សដែលគាត់ត្រូវបង្កើតបន្តអញ្ចឹងយើងមិនតែបង្រួមពង្រួមពួកគាត់ឲ្យគាត់បានសម្លឹងមើលឲ្យគាត់បានអធិដ្ឋានឲ្យគាត់នោះម្នាក់ឲ្យគាត់បានចាប់ម្នាក់ពីរនាក់ដើម្បីបង្រួមពង្រួមសិស្សបន្តដល់ដៃគូដែរបាទសូមជួយអធិដ្ឋានសម្រាប់ពលនិកិច្ចក្រុមជំនុំព្រះ7ហើយអធិដ្ឋានសម្រាប់ពលនិកិច្ចទាំងអស់នេះការបង្ការសិស្សអជិបង្ការសិស្សបន្តនឹងឲ្យដំណើរការល្អឲ្យព្រះអង្គម្ចាស់បានប្រទានពរដល់ពួកគាត់ឲ្យមាននិមិត្តជាមួយនឹងជុំហើយដើម្បីឲ្យពួកគាត់មានអំណោយទីនៃការបម្រើព័ត៌មានក្នុងគុំជុំរបស់គ្នាដើម្បីឲ្យមានការរីកចម្រើនបានឈានទៅមុខដែលយើង2026យើងដើរទៅខាងឯងបាទហើយនឹងគុតគង់ដល់គូរវាលតលយើងសង្ឃឹមថា2026នឹងបានសម្រេចតាមអ្វីដែលយើងបានធ្វើដោយមកពីព្រះអង្គហើយជំនួយដល់មកពីព្រះអង្គដោយជំនួយមកអរគុណបងប្អូនអរគុណដែលនៅសង្ឃួយជាដៃគូបានអធិដ្ឋានសម្រាប់ការងារហើយអរគុណសម្រាប់ដៃគូដែលនៅសង្ឃួយរយៈពេល10ឆ្នាំជាងកន្លងមកដែលជួយឧបត្ថម្ភដល់យុវជនកុមារទាំងព្រះវិហារទាំងដីនិងគ្រប់ការទាំងអស់បាទគឺជាប្រគុណដែលព្រះអង្គបានធ្វើការសម្រាប់ក្រុមជំនុំព្រះ7ហើយសូមព្រះអង្គប្រទានពរដល់ដៃគូហើយនិងគូរួមក្នុងក្រុមជំនុំទាំងគណៈកម្មការតែគុំគុំអស់អង្គការជំនាញបាទគុំសូមអរគុណ
Praise the Lord. We've just heard from Pastor Ratana and Pastor Sopor. Actually, over the pandemic, it wasn't simply just getting cameras, connecting to internet and live streaming services. Pastor also went to the houses, the homes of church members and have multiple services on a Sunday, just so that he could keep touch with the church members as well. And we've also heard the plans of the church is disciple-making leadership development. You know, in cross-cultural missions, we always go in, we have to be careful not to bring in this mentality of a more developed country, not to bring in this mentality of we know better than you. In a cross-cultural setting, sometimes, even in very subtle ways, we say, back in Singapore, this is what we do. And that can be perceived as, hey, you are coming in, looking down on us, talking down to us. What is this new thing that the Lord is doing? The Lord is not here just for the Israelites. The Lord is not here just for Singaporeans. If we can do it, the Cambodians can do it, maybe even better. And I think in the next season of missions, we have to be intentional about leadership development. The Cambodian Methodist Church is at a crossroads right now where they are planning to be self-sustaining. Pastor talked about that as well. And so, lay leadership has to rise up. For them to take offices, to take leadership in the churches. Aldersgate has been going into Cambodia for many years, doing English classes, some of you will remember, IT classes, doing university scholarship, sponsorship programs. In the Methodist hostel as well, we've been doing leadership development classes. Uncle Alan went down and did one of them. And so we have been doing a lot. Let us continue to go in and share with them our journey of faith, not just in the church, but also in the secular world. How the Lord has led us through. I think it's no secret that a country like that, there is widespread corruption. And so how do we live our faith? Live out our faith in the marketplace when it is challenging, when it is the darkest. And as God's people, I think we have a responsibility to go and share and declare the praises of how God has made a way in that wilderness when our days look bleakest, and how the Lord can continue to do that in the present day. And I think this new thing is about leadership development for the Cambodian churches and also as a society. Let's continue to pray and seek the Lord how we cannot settle at just building a church, not settle at just giving out scholarships, but seek to go and make disciples in the nations as well. My personal reflection coming back from the field, as I finish 2 terms, 8 years, I ask myself, what have I left behind? What have I taken back with me? And the Lord showed me it is about relationships. It is about that disciple that I have journeyed with. I have a student from the Methodist School of Cambodia. He received a scholarship to go to the US for studies. On the day he returned back to Cambodia 1 year later, much like what our brother is doing this morning, he came down from the airport, he came straight to church, to school, waited for me 2 hours just to say hello to me. And that is, to me, the most precious thing ever. That relationship, that person that I've gotten to know, that person that I've been able to share lives with. And I think that's what missions is about. So church, this morning, as we continue to think about what the Lord would have us do to participate in missions, I'd like to end by leaving this thought from verses 20 and 21. The wild beasts will honor me, the jackals and ostriches, for I give water in the wilderness, rivers in the desert to give drink to my chosen people, the people who I formed for myself, that they may declare my praise. We are not there to plant a flag and to say we've been there, we've done that. We are there to declare God's praises. All honor and glory be unto his name. And with that, I'd like to share with you how our brothers and sisters are thankful and giving God praise in their life and how the Lord has touched their life. And you look out for familiar faces.
ខ្ញុំសរសើរដល់ការព្រះព្រោះព្រះជាព្រះពិតខ្ញុំសរសើរដល់ការព្រះដោយសារទ្រង់គឺជាព្រះអង្គសង្គ្រាមខ្ញុំសរសើរដល់ការព្រះដោយសារទ្រង់គឺជាព្រះអង្គសង្គ្រាមខ្ញុំសរសើរដល់ការព្រះដោយសារទ្រង់ជាព្រះអង្គម្ចាស់ហើយជាព្រះអង្គសង្គ្រាមរបស់ខ្ញុំខ្ញុំសរសើរដល់ការព្រះដោយសារព្រះគឺជាព្រះសង្គ្រាមអ្នកទាំងអស់គ្នា
Praise the Lord. As we look to the travel lane opening, as we book flight tickets, let's also think about booking a flight ticket for a short-term mission trip to Cambodia and meeting old friends, familiar faces, and sharing how the Lord has been so good to us in our lives. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, you are the Lord of the nations. You are the King of kings, the Lord of lords. This morning, Lord, we worship you and we enthrone you on the throne of our hearts. And we ask, O Lord, just as you have revealed yourself to us, we want to be your hands and feet, to reflect your goodness, declare your praises to the nations, because you have commanded us to do so. And Lord, we want to bring your love, your gospel, your hope, your peace, your joy to the nations, to the people around us. We give you thanks and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.